Hi everyone, and welcome to my new YouTube video series called EasyFEM, Easy Codes for Finite Element Analysis. This is my channel called OriDos. In this video series, I will cover the development of fast and easy codes for finite element analysis purposes. I will go into the details of algorithms and data structures required for developing a fast and user-friendly finite element code. In this video series, I will use MATLAB for coding and implementing all components of our finite element engine, as it is a user-friendly software without any overhead and is freely available for students. However, I will have a separate video series for those interested in Python covering these topics. So please make sure to subscribe to the channel for upcoming videos. For this video series, I will assume you have the basic knowledge and background of the finite element method. However, if you don't have any experience, don't worry about it. Instead, please check out my upcoming video series about the theoretical background and introduction to the finite element method. At the end of the series, I promise our developed code will be able to solve different physical problems such as structural mechanics, heat transfer, fluid dynamics, and coupled multiphysics problems. All right, let's get started. First, I will draw the big picture of our EasyFEM workflow and the things I am planning to cover in this video series. First, I am going to talk about model and geometry initialization and ways to discretize geometries for finite element applications. Initially, I will discuss developing a mesh generation engine for structured domains using MATLAB. However, in the future, I will include unstructured domains as well. In the model initialization, I will talk about developing and implementing the weak form of governing equations, primarily for structural mechanics applications. Then, I will talk about the interpolation scheme in the finite element method, and, more specifically, developing a shape function engine. Following the interpolation scheme, I will also talk about the numerical integration scheme in finite element analysis. In the final part of model initialization, I will discuss different boundary conditions and how to implement these boundary conditions. Moving forward to the core part of our workflow, I will talk about the time integration scheme and time solvers, and how to implement time solvers efficiently. Within the core part of our workflow, I will also talk about linear and nonlinear solvers like Newton's method, and how to implement them. Following, I will talk about implementing a finite element assembler. Then, I will go into the details of elemental routine and computing, for example, elemental stiffness matrix and force vector, how to pass them into the global system, and how to efficiently assemble the global system of equations. Next, I will discuss MATLAB's parallelization of the global finite element assembly. Moving forward, I will talk about solving the linearized system of equations, and how to use MATLAB Direct and Iterative Solver efficiently. Then, I will talk about convergence criteria in the finite element method. And finally, I will talk about implementing a post-processor to visualize the finite element analysis solution. For all of these topics, I will walk through implementation schemes and how we can develop our finite element engine. And here is the entire workflow I am going to cover in this video series. Alrighty, this is the end of this video. Please make sure to subscribe to the channel for upcoming videos, and give thumbs up for videos. At the end of this video series, I can assure you will be able to have your finite element code, and could be able to solve different problems. Thank you. Looking forward to having you in my next video.